People have been making money in 2020 despite all the issues, despite all the problems, people making money. So I want to look at some of the best investments. People keep asking me, which investments should I take? What are the best investment vehicles for this year and possibly in the near future, 2021, 2022, 2023? So I want to look at some of the best investments for 2020, and we hope that they will also be the best investments for 2021 or going into the future. Some of them, of course, are really good investments for long-term purposes, and you don't have to worry about 2021 or so, as long as you do it the right way. Like I say, talk to an advisor, talk to a financial coach, let them know your situation, your goals. And it is extremely important, guys, make sure you speak to someone before you jump into these investments. So this is not an advice, this is a recommendation. And of course, if you want something that is more tuned to you, reach out, guys. So investing is a very interesting game. And like I just always say, it's one of the things that you need to start doing now for you to build wealth properly in the near future or later for generations. But there are certain static rules when it comes to investment. It doesn't matter what kind of investment I'm going to talk about. You must be well diversified. So you don't have a portfolio that if everything goes down, then everything, all the eggs are broken. Have a well-diversified portfolio. Stay diversified. And number two, I always say automate your investing. Make sure it is for the long term. If you automate the investing, if you ensure that your investments always happen despite what's happening, you will get to your goals. So automate your investing, diversify as much as possible. And number three, keep the fees low. Make sure that you keep your fees low. And this way, you don't have to worry much about, you know, part of your portfolio paying the management of that particular portfolio. So keeping your fees low will help you achieve your goals much faster, because again, these fees do accumulate and become so much in a long-term investment. So if you follow those three rules, you will sure get where you're going to. And then now, let's dive in into some of the best investments. What are some of the best investments of 2020? Number one, S&P 500 index fund investing. S&P 500, like I say, is index fund investing strategy, whereby you are tracking the whole market. You're tracking a basket of stocks, well-diversified, cost-effective, very consistent returns in a long time. So if you're looking at one of the best investments for 2020, I suggest and I recommend that you get into the S&P 500. It has some of the best companies in the US. It has some of the biggest and best performing companies, and it's been very stable, very consistent, and it is low fees, which is very important for investors. You have to ensure that you have something that is low fees. It doesn't cost you so much to manage. It doesn't cost you so much to buy. It doesn't cost you so much to run. So again, you also want something that is efficient in that it doesn't consume so much time. Picking out stocks is very difficult. And sometimes this kind of investing is good for those who are working. You don't have to worry about anything. So one of the best investments is the S&P 500. If you want more information about it, check my video on index fund investing versus picking of stocks. Number two is treasury bonds and treasury bills. And this depends on whichever country you are in. If you're in Kenya, you're in the UK, you're in the US, they have performed well. Looking at it this way, the markets got so messed up sometime early this year because of the coronavirus. And usually the bonds perform really well when things are going down with the stock market. So again, you have to ensure that you have some bonds in your portfolio. Treasury bonds are very guaranteed, they're very safe, and again, they still give good returns when things are not going so well with stocks. So treasury bills and treasury bonds, that's another good investment that a lot of people would want to look into this year. And especially those who are older, I would say above 60, they want to diversify their portfolio, they want to take less risk. This is the best place to be. Don't keep your money in the bank. Think of the treasury bills, treasury bonds, think of municipal bonds and such stuff. Basically, it is all IOUs. So there's another vehicle, there's another opportunity for those who want to diversify their portfolio, go into treasury bonds and treasury bills. Check it out in whichever country you are in. Make sure you are investing and taking those opportunities instead of keeping your money in the bank and losing it. So number three, the third best investment in 2020 has been growth stocks. Growth stocks is basically those stocks that are expected to grow much faster than the average market rate. So let's say the S&P 500 is growing at a rate of like 5%, for example, annually. This is expected maybe to do 7-8%. So they are very aggressive. They are stocks that are expected to do really well, and they're usually more expensive in the market. So their shares could be a bit more expensive than other stocks, but the returns are also expected to be really good. They rarely pay dividends. They don't always pay dividends, but it's because the investors expect to retain or to get some capital gains out of this growth stock. So that's the reason they get into growth stocks. And they have been quite good. People have actually made money in the biotechnology sector. It's been amazing because of the coronavirus thing. So things that to happen with vaccine, health and stuff. People are also becoming very aware of their health. So this has really done well. There are certain stocks that have done so well in 2020, and I would classify some of them as growth stocks because they were expected to grow well. And of course, there are also growth stocks for 2021. There are also growth stocks for the next 10 years or so. But again, you have to have the information to get this right. So growth stocks, that's another good investment that has happened in 2020, and it's also good looking into 2021. The fourth best investment vehicle for 2020 has been the NASDAQ 100. This was an index, basically. So it traces the 100 largest traded companies in the US, and most of them are, not most of them, but all of them are non-financials. So we're talking about things that do not involve banks and financial institutions. We're looking at healthcare, we're looking at biotechnology, we're looking at technology, we're looking at things that are like industrial. So basically, this is one area that has really grown in 2020, and we're expecting to see a good growth in 2021. So the NASDAQ 100, for those who have access to this index, it's a good opportunity to invest into it and hope to get some good returns in the future. But again, like I say, make sure you're investing for long term and for the right reasons. So make sure you do some more research on this. But this is one of the indexes that has done really, really well. The NASDAQ 100, non-financials basically. So this is a stock you definitely want to look into and put some money into it. And now we go to one of my best, which is the real estate investment trusts. Like I say, you don't have to just buy houses and lands. You can still invest in houses or real estate or properties to let through the stock market. So if you buy REITs, which we call the real estate investment trusts, you're still managing to own these things, but not directly. So it eliminates the hassle of making sure that your house is okay, making sure that the tenants are paying, making sure that everything is working as they should. So again, me, I love real estate investment trusts, and it's one of the investments that has done really well. And like we say, it's one of the best investments to have in your portfolio. I always tell people, I recommend having real estate investment trust in your portfolio. So make sure that despite having stocks, despite having bonds, despite having some cash in your portfolio, have some real estate in your portfolio, because it will help cushion your portfolio in case anything happens. So that diversification helps a lot, because everything else you may have in the stock market, but the real estate is now out of the stock market, ensuring that your portfolio is secure in any particular market condition. So yes, REITs has been really good, and this is still going to be really good in the near future. So if you want to invest and you want to create a portfolio, I recommend looking into real estate investment trusts. Like I said, what they do is they invest in these properties for you. So you don't have to directly invest in a property or buy a property. These stocks are investing in those kind of properties. Basically, you indirectly own or own a piece of them, basically. Another one that is not so much of my favorite, certificate of deposits. So for those who want to deposit money, if you have a large amount of cash, or if you invested and you still have some cash you want to put somewhere else, certificates of deposits has done well so far for those who want to have the diversification and ensure they have some money or some money that can they can liquidify as fast and as easy as possible. Certificate of deposits is basically deposits in a bank. You look for high yielding savings account, and they give you good returns, good interest rates. Make sure that you're getting the best in wherever you are. So if you're in a different state in the US, if you are in the UK, make sure you are getting the best high yielding savings accounts for this certificate of deposits. So again, like I said, certificate of deposits are much safer, and that's why investors do prefer them in their portfolio. So some people may have invested in the stocks, in the bonds, in the REITs, as mentioned, and they also have some cash maybe in their portfolio, but they still want some CDs because, again, they give you good interest rates. And like I say, you have to shop around, make sure you get the best certificate of deposits, because all banks have their own terms, they have their own contracts, details, so make sure you're getting the best. It is a good investment for some people. I definitely do not have certificate of deposits because I don't like them, but maybe later as I age, I will look into this. But again, people's situations are different. Everyone have their own unique way of approaching investment. So if you like this one, get into it and make some money this year.